Well, this looks familiar, doesn't it? Some generous fan was able to donate to me the Wii version of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Smash Up. Which now means this right here, you see this? This is what the complete game on the Wii looks like. Which means I can now do the four characters that I was originally supposed to do. Because if you remember, I have the PS2 version, but someone was nice enough to donate the Wii version. So yes, this won't be a week of, but we will get through these four characters. Yes, they're four separate characters, and they each have their own unique moveset, which is okay, I guess. So yes, survival mode, starting with, for some reason, the one character that's a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles character and isn't in the PS2 version.
Fugitoid,
that's how you say it, Fugitoid. Let's go!
Oh, this will be an interesting
and you know what's funny about the Wii version compared to the PS2 version? The Wii version actually has other stuff too. Like, it has mini-games. Granted, they're not that great. And there are a bunch of Smash Brothers like knockoff mini-games. There's like a race to the finish, board the platforms kind of thing. Eat as many peaches as you can, which is basically breaking targets. And the load times are 10 times better in this than in the PS2 version, surprisingly. Like, there's like non-existent load times in this game. PS2 version, if you saw my playthroughs of the PS2 version, a lot of load times. Anyway, Fugitoid! He, out of the turtle, like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles characters, he's probably the worst character. He's slow, he's clunky, he's big, but he has a cool throw, which is great. This move, this laser, you see that? When it turns red, that's when it actually hits them. That green thing, the green part, doesn't hit them. And that's his special move. That too, that little tackle, which is funny looking, but isn't that great. Oh god, my face. Sorry, Raph. Goodbye. Anyway, yeah, Fugitoid, probably the worst character in the game out of the turtle characters, like the actual Ninja Turtle characters. But yeah, it's kind of nice to revisit this game. Because in my top 10 videos, maybe 15 actually, a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle Smash Up video is actually one of my highest viewed videos on my channel. It's Night Watcher there, his survival mode playthrough. But yeah, thank you very much. The person who donated this to me said, please don't use my name, just do the gameplay of the characters. And I was like, alright. So, thank you, person who donated this to me. As I promised, won't say your name. But yeah, it's actually kind of nice to get back into this game and see the four characters that for some reason weren't in the PS2 version. And no, I won't be showing any of the mini games, if that's what you want to call them, in this version. But I still stand by saying that, surprisingly, this is one of the best turtle games. Well, I can't really say that because there's not really that many good ones. But yes, if you're gonna get this game, I suggest getting the Wii version. Just because it's more complete than the PS2 version. The PS2 version is kind of gimped. It doesn't have the mini games. Granted, they're not really that fun, but still. And four extra characters. Yeah. So yeah, I'm one of those people that believe more content equals a better game. So, all right, Fugitoid. What else is there to say about him besides he sucks? He sucks. They got Shredder. Oh no. Aha! Take that. Oh, I used up all of them. But yeah, Fugitoid. He's just bad. He's slow, clunky, as I said. That's funny to use, that little windmill punch he has. But other than that, other than his throw too, like his side throw is great. But it's always, his corner throw is pretty funny too, just slamming him against the corner and suplexing them. But yeah, this, that is completely useless. Stay away from the the laser, unless you're in a free-for-all brawl. You know what's funny about the, see, look at that, I just got him from the distance. You gotta time it just right. Funny about this version, survival mode, is you'll see every character, including the rabbits. Which, yes, I'll be doing a rabbits video. Also, this version has two extra stages that the PS2 version doesn't have. It has the Technodrome, which you unlock by putting in the code for the Ninja Rabbit. And it has the Rabbit's home stage, which some people are saying it's not their home stage, but this game came out around the time that that Rabbit's Go Home game was coming out. That's why I think Ubisoft used this game as a promotional thing. You know what? More about the Rabbits when I get to the Rabbits. This is all about Fugitoid survival.
Oh dear.
Oh dear. And you know what's funny too? Fugitoid just appeared on the recent cartoon. Which is like, I was like, hey, I get this game. Fugitoid's on the cartoon now. Spoilers, by the way. But I haven't been keeping up with the cartoon. It's on, what is it, Sunday mornings? And I work Sunday mornings. And I know I could watch him on demand and whatnot, but he has a funny dive attack. There you go, Karai. But some fun facts about Smash Up on my channel. The two highest viewed videos are Night Watcher survival mode and the Foot Ninja, which I'm a little surprised about. Not just any Foot Ninja, the Cyber Foot Ninja. And yes, there's still all these characters still don't have alternate costumes, like Ultraminator doesn't get an alternate costume, Fugitoid doesn't get an alternate costume, none of the rabbits have alternate costumes unless you count the three rabbits as non-separate characters, I should say. But no, they don't have alternate costumes. Casey, what are you doing? Stop jumping. Aha! I ran out. Yeah, as I said, I like Fugitoid's forward and back throw. Reminds me of Purdy from Street Fighter. Street Fighter Alpha. Dear God. What the hell was Ultraminator doing? He's just walking. That little rabbit punch thing is pretty funny. Basically, Fugitoid's just a joke character, and it's funny because he's one of the hardest ones to unlock. You have to complete all, like, I think it's 50 missions in mission mode to unlock Fugitoid. And you can either be the last character you unlock or one of the first characters. Which is funny because he's an actual Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle character, and if he's the first character you unlock, that means one of the rabbits will be your last character you unlock, depending on how you play the game. I'll put that out there. He's gonna die right when he spawns. Yeah, double KO. And as I said before, this game isn't bad. It just, it's like what Game Trailer said in their review. It makes you want to play Smash Brothers. Which, I think I'm going to play some Smash Brothers when I'm done recording these little videos. And, as I said in my Street Fighter Cross Tekken video, this will probably be the only time, besides the Rabbit videos, that I revisit this game unless I get a request. But, if you wish to see any other Smash Up videos, I have an entire playlist of the 7 characters you can play through in arcade mode and survival mode with the other characters. In survival mode, you have to get at least 100 KOs to actually win, and we're only at 42. And you might notice with this video and with the next 2 or 3 Rabbids videos, it's a little upscale to 720p. I got a little scaling converter there. See how well it comes out. Because I liked it with some of my DBTC stuff, so I'm seeing how well this converter works. Get out of here. No, no. How the hell did I do that? How the hell did I do the hammer thing? Ah, that's how. Okay, it's hammer time. Get up, Fugitoid. There we go. Wow, that was a glitch. I'm gonna get up. That too, this game has a lot of, like, strange glitches. From, oh dear god. Like, if you do a versus mode, and say one character wins, that character might not do the victory animation. It might be somebody who came in last place winning. Which kind of makes you wish they had a patch for this game then. Look at this hammer. Look at that hammer. Well, Future Toy's got some other moves apparently that I'm not aware of. That's like his best move though. Apparently, if you hold a direction on the controller stick, you stay down on the ground. Strange. When you get knocked down. It's a... No, that's not what I want. Oh, apparently, there's other stuff I just figured out too in this game. Instead of just being three-hit combos, you can alternate, like, between strong and heavy attacks. Damn it, Karai, you screwed up my chain. We're halfway there. 50 KOs out of supposed 100. Damn it! Stop it, Donnie. Right. I'm gonna throw this person into the wall. Here's a little exploit. Throw him into Never mind. Depending on the character you use, like Karai. For those of you who want Karai's alternate outfit in this game, if you want her alternate outfit, you have to complete survival mode. I suggest doing a tag team survival mode with her and the Foot Ninja. Because that's the only way to unlock their alternate outfits. And with Karai, she has a really good wall throw. She throws you to the wall, and they stay right next to you. When you do that, jump up in the air after they're on the ground, and use your down air attack. It's an instant, like, KO, no matter what. Like, well, the first, I want to say, like, 30 throws into the wall will be an automatic KO, just because... Depending on what difficulty you play too. Like I'm playing on easy just because I don't know how to use Future Toy. And I'm not sure if there's a I can't remember if there's a special win pose at the end of what is it called here, survival mode. Yeah, see that laser attack is awful. Even though I was able to get Night Watcher and Michelangelo.
My, you are a strange creature.
His dive attack's hilarious. Ah! It's winter in April. When do the rabbits appear? I know on certain difficulties the rabbits will. Even on easy difficulty the rabbits would appear. This is the only mode where you'll be able to fight all characters except for versus mode. As I said too, the Wii version's arcade mode has mini games like in between. Okay, that's not what I wanted. I wanted to get the pizza, thank you. There you go, Donnie, just stand there, take it like a man. Or turtle, whatever you are. You're turtle of the mutant variety. Oh, now we got 3-on-1 here. It's okay. Foot Ninja, figures it's all the evil people too, surprisingly. All you need is Utrominator in there. Look at this, they're air dodging all my attacks. What the hell, man? Oh, look out. Figures it comes down to Shredder and Karai, right? Oh, now it comes down to just Shredder, and guess what? It's a shocking experience for the Shredmeister. Oh, thank you. Alright. Utrominator, speak of the devil. He's basically this game's version of Krang. Utrominator, as I said in his video. Funny, he was created exclusively for this game, too. A face! Night Watcher and Leonardo, huh? That's an interesting pair. Not really. I'm only saying it's interesting because in the movie they fought one another. Spoilers. I'll give Ubisoft credit where credit is due. They made a fighting game in which there's no two identical characters. Like, every character has their own unique moveset. None of them are clones. Even though they all somewhat play similar because with Smash the controls are all the same. With all characters, but I should say they all control similar. But yeah, they've made a complete, not really a complete game, in my opinion. As I said, you had the TMNT license, and you go ahead and kind of spoil it by putting your own characters in it. But yeah, every character has their own unique moveset, which is surprising compared to some fighting games nowadays, where you'll have like a 12 character roster, but three of those characters will be clone characters from other characters. this game has, what, 20 characters, I want to say? And the Wii version, it's funny. The Wii version had online mode. But if you get the PS2 version, it'll say it has online mode. Which, I'm surprised, whoever made the box for that did not get fired or sued for false advertisement or something like that, because you can't play online on the PS2 version. Not now, not ever. And then the Wii version, unless you've hacked your Wii or something to play online, but you could still play this game online, but I don't have a hacked Wii. I still play my Wii somewhat religiously because sometimes the Wii had some nice games, and it's easier to record my GameCube games on the Wii. Shredder. Oh yeah, Future Toys animations are pretty cool too. Like that ground slam, that's cool looking. Raphael has the best sound effects in the game when he gets hit. Give me the damn. Thank you. The wind. Okay, use the wind. Oh, he's dead. No, he's not dead. He's getting to the. He's dead now. We're at 80, right? Yeah. Well, apparently, if you don't kill him quick enough, they'll start spawning. Who is this? Donatello? Just spawned in player 2 spot. Or player 3. Oh, look out. Gotcha. Alright. Future Toys, one clunky looking bastard. Where the hell are the rabbits? They usually appear in this. Strange. Get away from me, stupid foot ninja. It's funny, on the tier list, foot ninja is considered the best character in the game. I don't know why, but I looked up the tier list and foot ninja is considered the best character. Ah! Splinter just appearing out of nowhere. Let me get out of here. Let's do the up throw. Yeah! The reason why I want to fight a rabbit is because I'm... Oh, look! Fugitoid! Another Fugitoid. Because when you grab the rabbits, they grab them by the ears, which is hilarious. And it's like the only good redeeming factor about the rabbits in this game is that you get to beat them up. Because, no offense to people who like the raving rabbits, I don't like them. I never liked them. Take this, Shredder! My longest range attack, and it's terrible. Oh, hey, pizza. I'm a robotic alien from outer space. Hey, there's a ninja rabbit! Alright, come here, little guy. Ninja Rabbit actually is somewhat of a clone of Leonardo. Not completely, don't quote me on that, but he has some similar moves like Leonardo. Oh god, come on. Ninja Rabbit, stop it. Take that. But, if I had to choose a rabbit to be in this game as a guest character, it'd have to be Ninja Rabbit just because, you know. Oh, look, you fight. This is the last fight, I think. Because you usually fight all three of these guys in their alternate costumes. No, I think you fight actually everybody else in their alternate costumes. This is a little different. Die! Oh, and also, what I mentioned earlier about doing a team survival mode. Team survival mode is 10 times easier than normal survival mode. I should actually do that with the rabbits, but not going to. Good. No, Donnie. Thank you. Alright. I think they start sending three after you now. Yep. What's the matter? Scared? They both said that. Hilarious. Yeah, they start sending every character that has an alternate costume after you now. Oh, look out! Okay, I tried to kill a laser, but that didn't work. I don't see me completing this. Why did I use that? Why didn't I just do his tackle attack or his little punchy punch? Just keep punching. April has the most health and the highest defense right now out of all of these guys. Correction, April's dead. Splinter's dead. I'm dead. I'm not dead. I am dead. I'm not dead. I like that too when you KO Casey, his mask falls off. Aw, oh, damn it, Karai! You got me. Well, 94 with Fugitoid there. I hope you enjoyed this TMNT Smash Up Survival Mode with Fugitoid. Stay tuned for the Raving Rabbids. Yay! My name's Clickerbot. I thank you so much for watching.